हेलो, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन.
इन द नेम ऑफ ऑल माय डियर द आई एम शेरिल जफरी
एंड टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द कोड फॉर स्टॉपवॉच इन असेंबली लैंग्वेज. हियर आई एम यूजिंग अ पिक माइक्रो कंट्रोलर पिक 18F452 एंड अ फोर डिजिट मल्टीप्लेक्सर एलईडी व्हिच हैज फोर सिलेक्शन बिट्स एंड हैज सेवन इनपुट्स फॉर एलईडी ब्लिंकिंग अप द एलईडी. And let me run the simulation. Here, if you press the start button, so the simulation, so the stopwatch will start. Here is a button for pausing the stopwatch. If you press, so the stopwatch is pressed. And here I introduced a special function in this stopwatch, which is 10 second increment. If you press in this button, so there will be an increment of 10 seconds, just like that. So let's come to the code. Here it is the code for stopwatch. Here I declared some register and I specified their location, which will be used in the program. And here I declared that I am starting from the location 500H. Now here is my data, which I bind in ROM, my data. And if you write all this hexadecimal number in binary, so you will come to know that this 3F is displaying 0, 4, 7 segment, and this 06 is displaying 11, 4 in case 4, 7 segment, and this 5B is 3, and this 4H is 4, and this 5, 6, this is 7, this is 8, this is 9. Is it okay? And here I made my port D and port B as an output port. And here I selected the pins of port C, pin 0, pin 1, pin 2 as an input pin. These pins are used for the start, pause and 10 increment button. And in this section I set the location of my table pointer. I am doing this by table pointer. 1 minute. Now here I setted the location of my table pointer to 500H. You guys can see, and in this section I gave the value 0 to the digit second and to all the registers I declared. I will explain here that why I declared these registers. Now here is a start the button of start. Here is the function for it. If the start button is not pressed, so this loop will go on forever. And if the start button is pressed, so due to this instruction, it will skip this instruction and go to here. And then if it goes to here, so the code for my stopwatch starts. And here I made a subroutine for display function. I will explain the display function later in this code. And here there is a function for the 10 second increment, and this will be explained later. And now in the start, there is an increment of 1 in the first digit of the LED. This is the first digit, this is labeled as second one. This the resistors labeled as second one is dealing with the first digit of my stopwatch. And then now I moved a literal value of 9H, that if the value of second digit is 9 or greater than 9, okay? Is it okay? So it will skip this instruction and move to here. And what if it is less than 9? And if it is less than 9, so it will repeat this loop and start and display the first digit from 0 to 9. Is it okay? And then if it is equal to 9, so it will come here and it will increment in the second digit of this stopwatch to display the second digit. Just like that, here it is, it will increment in the second digit compare it with 5h, here it is. It will increment in the second digit. Compare it with 5h, and if it is not greater than, so it will come to this instruction and repeat the whole procedure. And if this digit is greater than 5, instead of this digit is not greater than 5, if this digit is equal to or greater than 5, so it will skip this instruction and come to here. So now what is going on here? It will increment in the third digit, which is min 1 of the stopwatch, and compare it with 9. Compare it with 9. If the digit in min means register is equal to 9, so it will skip this instruction and come to display the 4th digit of my LED, 4 of my multiplexer LED. Now it will increment in the min 1 and compare it with 5h, and if it is equal to or greater equal to means 1, then it will skip this instruction and it will start the whole code again, just like that. Now let's come to the display function, that how I am displaying my code, displaying the digits. I here the value of second one, which is the second, which is the first digit, and the second one, which is the second digit, and the means, which is the which is for third digit, and the min one, which is for the fourth digit. I move all this value into the register num 1, num 2, num 3, num 4, and I have set in my location of table pointer lower to 0h. And then I move the value of num1, which is second, to the working register, and I add it into the value of my table pointer lower, which is first 0, and then it will update itself as per to the value of second. Now here I use the instruction tbldr, which is to use the table pointer, and here as it reads the value from table pointer, and then it moves it to the port D. Now the most important thing in this code is this, that how I am displaying it on 7 segment. Now here what I did is actually my port B is used for data selection. You can see that port B, that the buttons of that the pins of port B is going to the selection bits. Is it okay? First I move the literal value 0001110. What will this do? If this first three pins of this is 0001111, my LED is common cathode, so it means that it is active low. If I am giving 111 with the pin, so it means that it is off. If I am giving 000, so it means that all the LEDs are on. Now what I did here, I first turned on only the first digit where I want to send my data. Is it okay? Where I want to send my data from the table pointer. And then I called a delay of 10 milliseconds, and then I turned off this LED. Is it okay? And then after that, if I want to display the digit 2, I send my value of num 2, which is the value of second digit. And then I set my table pointer lower to num2, and then I used an instruction to read the value, and then I moved the value from my table pointer to port D. And now here I want to display my second digit, so I turned on only my second pin. So I turned on only the second pin, pin 3, and I turned off all the pins, and then I moved this value to the port B to turn on only my second pin, and then I call the delay, and then I moved my little value 111 to turn off all the LEDs, all the, and after that I displayed the digit 3 in the same manner by turning on the third LED only, and then I displayed the digit 4 by turning on only the fourth LED. And here is the function for 10 second increment. Let me go up. Here it is, 10 second increment. If the button of 10 second increment it is pressed, so it will increment in 1 in the second digit. By incrementing the second digit of my stopwatch, there so there will be an increment of 10 seconds. And in my stopwatch, the second, the value of second digit can't be more than 5. So I will move little value 6 into my working register, and I compare it with my, with the little value second. If the value of second digit is lesser than second, so it will skip this instruction and goes here. And if it is greater than 6, and if it is equal to or greater than 6, so what will this instruction do? This instruction will go to the label means here, and it will increment into the third digit of my stopwatch. Just simple is that if this digit is greater than 6, so it means that this digit needs to be incremented by 1. So here this subroutine is doing the function. Okay, so here is the code for my stopwatch, and I will also upload this code into the description of my video, and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you.